2018 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine jointly to James P. Allison and Tasco Honjo for their discovery of cancer therapy by inhibition of negative immune regulation.
What I was told by the Nobel Committee when I was called this morning that this was the first prize they'd ever given for cancer therapy. And so they've given some for cancer, the causing cancer before, but this is the first time for cancer therapy. And I'd like to just give a shout out to all the patients out there who are suffering from cancer to let them know that, you know, we are making progress now.
来会会2018年诺贝尔医学奖得主70岁的 James Allison， 一位与众不同的教授。
I think I'm an exceptionally lucky guy because when the trials of the drug I invented were going on, it came clear that it worked.
This new wave of cancer-fighting drugs called immunotherapy come in part from the lab and the brain of this scientist, Dr. James Allison, and his partner and wife, Dr. Padmini Sharma.
So now there's a whole field called immune checkpoint blockade, and that's immunotherapy that we know of today in the clinic.
对于 Allison 博士来说，由他所创的免疫检查点阻断疗法有着特殊的意义。
I got to see firsthand the way that both radiation, which my mother got, and chemotherapy, which one of my uncles got, how it ravages the body and how just terrible how the side effects.
Immunologist James Allison never set out to cure cancer. For decades, his research focused on how the immune system works. But his family history with the disease and his life's work intersected in the 1990s when he made a stunning discovery, a way to use the body's own immune system to hunt down and kill cancer cells. When someone develops cancer, his immune system may not fight the tumor or even see it as a foreign invader.That's in part because of a protein called CTLA-4. Its main job is to tame the immune system so it doesn't run amok and attack healthy tissue. Dr. Allison and his team discovered an elegant workaround. If you use a drug that blocks the protein, you essentially take the brakes off the body's immune system, freeing it to fight cancer.
Not so much harnessing the immune system, but just unleashing it to attack whatever it was going to attack.
In the 2000s, researchers tested a CTLA-4 antibody developed by Dr. Allison. Ipilimumab, or Ipi, was given to hundreds of patients with advanced melanoma that had metastasized to other parts of their bodies. On average, such patients survive less than a year. And while only a minority of patients in the trial responded to Ipi, researchers were soon struck by how long many of those who benefited were surviving.
We know objectively that we could, for 20-something percent of melanoma patients, basically cure them to the extent that they're going to be around for a decade. They can be confident after about 2.5 years that they're going to be around for another decade.
These super survivors are now transforming the world of oncology and immunotherapy, which has long been written off as ineffective.The FDA approved Ipi in 2011, marketed as Yervoy, and it continues to show promising results.
MD Anderson 癌症中心在治疗多型性胶质母细胞瘤得到的数据显示，患者存活的长短与体内 PD-1 的多寡有关。PD-1 数值偏高者，存活率较低。而 PD-1 的研究正是今年与 Allison 博士一同获得诺贝尔医学奖的日本京都大学高等研究院副院长本树佑教授所研究的范畴。
诺贝尔生理学賞をいただくことになりまして、大変名誉なことだと喜んでおります。
根据本树教授的研究，身体内的免疫细胞会对外来的病毒进行攻击。但是在遇到癌细胞的时候，免疫细胞却不会发动攻击。本树教授发现，免疫细胞上有一种称为 PD-1 蛋白质，是除了 CTLA-4 之外的另一个免疫细胞刹车装置。癌细胞就是利用 PD-1 关闭 T 细胞的攻击。
この発見により、再び免疫が働くようにして、人の体が本来持っている免疫にがん細胞を攻撃させるオプジーボという新しいタイプの治療薬開発につながりました。
68歳の佐藤喜代治、在2017年6月、診断出罹患肺癌和咽喉癌、無法開刀、也無法化療。 佐藤先生自今年一月起接受注射，现在不但肿瘤缩小，甚至还能爬山了。
本当ね、信じられない問題の薬ですよね。
先前诊断出肺癌的日本前首相森喜朗，也是接受 Opdivo 注射治疗的人之一。
もうあの頃は自分がもうダメだと医者に言われてたから、もっと多くの患者にも採用されるようになればいいことだな。
在美国 MD Anderson 癌症中心，降低 PD-1 使用的是默克药厂的药。这个药最著名的使用者就是90多岁的美国前总统卡特。
They did an MRI and found that there were 4 spots of melanoma on my brain
and was being treated with a hard to pronounce drug named pembrolizumab.
I want all of you to remember that name, if you will, pembrolizumab.
Just a few months later, President Jimmy Carter said he was cured.
When I went this week, they didn't find any cancer at all. So I have good news.
现今的免疫疗法除了两位诺贝尔奖得主使用的免疫检查点阻断疗法，还有另一种是在实验室里将 T 细胞改造成专杀癌细胞的杀手，再注入回体内的治疗方法。
Therapy called CAR therapy, chimeric antigen receptor therapy. CARs are proteins that give T cells the ability to target tumor cells.
医生会先从病患的体内抽取出血液，从中挑选出 T 细胞进行改造，再输回病人体内对抗癌症。
We call this it's targeted therapies. Targeted because we use molecules with a kind of a warhead at the tip. These molecules have dialed in, programmed in, which are called antibodies. It's like a rocket that can recognize very specifically.A cell.
So it's like a heat-seeking missile finding the cancer cells.
That's exactly it.
整个过程大约需要3周的时间，而且 T 细胞的改造只能在特殊的医疗中心实验室进行。
After many years of resistance, I think the cancer field has begun to accept immunotherapy now as the fourth pillar, along with radiation surgery and chemotherapy, of cancer therapy. I think that immunotherapy is going to be part.It's not going to replace all those others, but it's going to be part of the therapy that essentially all cancer patients are going to be receiving in 5 years or so.
接下来要努力的目标是提高治愈率和扩展适用的癌症种类。
Melanoma survivor Sharon Belvin is one of the patients who responded to IPI after all other treatments failed.And she's the first IPI patient Dr. Allison ever met in person. Many researchers spend most of their time in laboratories and rarely meet the recipients of the drugs they develop. Ms. Belvin's oncologist invited Dr. Allison to meet her.
This is her first annual checkup, so she'd been tumor-free for a year. And that was amazing. I mean, everybody started crying and hugging each other.That's when it all came home, and I was lucky enough to stay in touch with her so much. She, about a year and a half or 2 years later, she sent me a photo of her first baby, and a year or so later, a photo of her second baby.
这一颗想要救人于水火的心，两位诺贝尔医学奖得主是一样的。
この治療法によって、重い病気から回復して。元気になったと、あなたのおかげだと言われる時があると本当に私としては、自分の研究が本当に意味があったということを実感し、何よりも嬉しく思っております。その上にこのような賞をいただき、大変、私は幸運な人間だというふうに思っております。
非常にね、感謝してます本当にね
あの薬がなかったら今どうなってるだろうと思うと恐ろしいですよねもう神様みたいですありがとうございました
ありがとうございます、
まあ、今後この免疫療法がこれまで以上に多くのがん患者を救うことになるように、まあ、一層私自身ももうしばらく研究を続けたいと思いますし世界中の多くの研究者がそういう目標に向かって努力を重ねておりますので、 この治療法がさらに発展するようになる期待しております。
We're treating the immune system, not the cancer. And so one of the implications of that, of course, is that this should work against all kinds of cancer. We just need to get the immune system to deal with it as we would with any virus.